क्वेश्चन नंबर वन, हियर वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट रेडियन वैल्यूज ऑफ दिस 63 डिग्री 14 मिनट्स एंड 51 सेकेंड्स. सो रेडियन वैल्यूज, द डेफिनेशन ऑफ दिस इज इन राइट एंगल ट्रायंगल वी डिवाइड अ राइट एंगल इनटू 90 इक्वल पार्ट्स, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज डिग्रीज, एंड दैट ईच डिग्री इज डिवाइडेड इनटू 60 इक्वल पार्ट इज कॉल्ड एज मिनट्स, एंड वेन अगेन वी डिवाइड दिस मिनट इनटू 60 इक्वल पार्ट दैट इज कॉल्ड एज सेकेंड्स. So one right angle triangle 90 degrees are there. So 1 degree is equals to 60 minutes and 1 minute is equals to 60 seconds. So finally 1 degree is pi by 180 radian. This is the definition. This way we have to find out the values of degrees in terms of radian. So this is 63 degree 14 minutes and 51 seconds. So we will multiply this with pi by 180. Now 63 degree plus 14 minutes, so 14 divided by 60, we have to convert it into the degree, plus 51 upon 60 into 60. The seconds are there, second into minutes, it comes in degree, into pi by 180. So let's solve 63 plus 0.234 plus 0.0142 into pi by 180. This is pi by 180 degrees. Now it comes 63.20142, so it must be near about 63.24 into pi by 180. Now again, instead of calculating further, what we will do, see 63 upon 180 means it must be one third value, so answer must be in the one third values, because here 2811 pi 8000 3815, these values are given, so our answer is one third, near about one third value. So what will come here, see answer is A, that we know. But this 3811 pi upon 8000 means, suppose this must be 4000 upon 8000 is half. This is nearly at half value, and this is nearly more than half value, and this is near about it must be 3/4 value. It must be near 3/4 value. Okay, so we need answer in one third value, because suppose this is 60 upon 180, so it must be 1/3, so answer must be near 1/3 values. So answer will be obviously A, because we will consider the 2811 pi upon 8000, because this is half, this cannot be the answer, and this cannot be the answer. So answer is A, 2811 pi upon 8000. So this is the answer, because it's near half, near one third value, that's why this is our answer. Instead of calculating for again 63.24 divided by 180, so by easier method is that convert this 63.24 and assume that this is 60 and this is 180, so one third. So this is the answer for 2811 pi upon 8000. Question number 2. Here we have to find out value of cos of 79 degree 53 minute 28 second plus tan of 10 degrees 6 minutes and 32 seconds. And it's also given sine of 10 degrees 6 minutes 32 seconds equals to A. So obviously, whatever value will come, it will be in terms of A. Let's find out. First, we will find cos of 79 degrees 53 minutes and 28 seconds. We will find out this value. So I can write this 79 degree as 90 minus this value. Now, because when I subtract 90 minus this angle, 79 degree 53 and 28 seconds, I'll get this 10 degree 6 minutes and 32 seconds. And also we know that cos of 90 minus theta is equals to sin theta. So this is sine of 10 degree 6 minutes and 32 seconds. Now here, how we got this value 10 degree 6 minutes and 32 seconds, I'll explain it. If I say 90 rupees, this 90 rupees, I can write it as 89 rupees plus 100 paisa also. Means 90 rupees is equals to 89 rupees plus 100 paisa. So, same way, same logic is here. If I am saying 90 degree, 0 minutes and 00 seconds. So, same thing I can write it as 89 degrees, 59 minutes and 60 seconds. Same logic, 90 rupees is 89 rupees plus 100 paisa. So that's why 89 degree, 59 minutes and 60 seconds. So I will subtract this 90 minus this 79 degree, 53 and 28. So 0 minus 10 minus 8 is 2, 6 minus 3 is 3, 9 minus 3 is 6, and this. So 10 degree 6 minutes and 32 seconds. So this way we got the value. So 90 minus 10, if I do 90 minus 10, I will get this value, 79, 53 and 28. So that's why. Now sine of 10 degree 6 minutes 32 seconds is equals to A, because it's given that sine of 10 6 32 is equals to A. So here we got the value of cos of 79 degree 53 minutes 28 seconds as a A value, same as given. Now for the second part, tan of 10 degree 6 minutes and 32 seconds, we know that tan theta is equals to tan theta is equals to sine theta upon cos theta. This is the basic formula. Now sine theta upon cos theta, here theta is this, theta means 10 degree 6 minutes 32 seconds. So it's given that this is A, value of this angle is A. Now cos of 10 degree 6 minutes 32 seconds, so we will find out first, because it's not given. So we know that cos square theta plus sin square theta equals to 1, this is the basic formula. Therefore cos square theta is equals to 1 minus sin square theta. So obviously cos theta is equals to under root of 1 minus sin square theta, and in this case sin square theta is given as, sin theta is given as A. So therefore cos theta is equals to under root of 1 minus A square. So cos theta here, sin theta is A, and cos theta is equals to under root of 1 minus A square. This way we got the value of tan of this. Now let's do all the values. So cos of this we got A, tan of this we got A upon under root of A minus 1 minus A square. Now do the cross multiplication, this A into this and A into 1. So A into under root of 1 minus A square plus A divided by under root of 1 minus A square. So we will take A common, because here A and here is also A, that's why we will take A common from the numerator, A, and value of here A 1, and here under root of 1 minus A square divided by under root of 1 minus A square. So this way we got the answer, value of this cos of 79 degree 53 minutes 28 second plus tan of 10 degree 6 minutes and 32 second is equals to A under root of A into 1 plus under root of 1 minus A square divided by 1 minus A square. Question number 3, cot theta minus cot theta. We know that cot theta is equals to cos theta upon sin theta minus cos 2 theta upon sin 2 theta. Now next step will be, we'll cross multiply this. So cos theta into sin 2 theta. Now this sin theta into cos 2 theta. So, and denominator will be sin theta, sin 2 theta. The next step will be, as we know that if there are cos theta, sin theta terms are there, minus sin. So by using this formula, sin of A minus B, sin A cos B minus cos A sin B. So answer will be sin of 2 theta minus theta. Denominator will be sin theta, sin 2 theta. So obviously 2 theta minus theta is sin theta, and denominator sin theta, sin 2 theta. Now in this term, sin theta will get cancelled. So next step, that is 1 upon sin 2 theta. So answer is cosec 2 theta. So this is the answer. Question number 4, cosec A plus cot A is equals to 11 by 2. And we have to find out the value of tan A. So only thing is given that cosec A plus cot A is equals to 11 by 2. So what we will do, as we know that cosec square A minus cot square A is equals to 1. This is the standard relation. Cosec square A minus cot square A is equals to 1. So we can write this equation as cosec A plus cot A. Similar, cosec A minus cot A. Why? Because we know that A square minus B square is equals to A plus B and A minus B. We know this relation. So we can write this cosec square A minus cot square A as cosec A plus cot A, and cosec A minus cot A is equals to 1. So from the equation 1, from this equation 1, we can write this cosec A plus cot A as 11 by 2 is given, and cosec A minus cot A is equals to 1. So cosec A, obviously cosec A minus cot A is equals to 2 by 11, because this 11 by 2 on the right hand side will become 2 by 11. So let's number this equation as number to equation. So we see we have to find out value of tan A. So what we will do, instead of solving this cos A k, we will try to find out value of cot A, because we know that cot A means 1 upon tan A. So or tan A is equals to 1 upon cot A, same thing. So what we will do, we will subtract the equation 1 and 2, because by subtracting this, we will, this cos A k will get cancelled. So equations 1 and 2. So let's, so this cot A plus minus cot A, what will become? Plus 2 cot A. See, when we subtract this cosec A plus cot A and cosec A minus cot A. So this will get cancelled, and this will become plus 2. So this will become plus 2. So plus 2A, similarly 11 by 2 minus 2 by 11. So by cross multiplication, 121 minus 4 divided by 22. Obviously, therefore, cot A is equals to 117 by 44. 117 by 44. As we got the value of cot A, we can find the value of tan A. So because tan A is equals to 1 upon cot A. That's why the answer will be 44 divided by 1 by 7. So this is the final answer of tan A. So this way we can, by using standard formulae, we can solve any equation. Question number 5, cos theta upon 1 minus sin tan theta plus sin theta upon 1 minus cot theta. So we have to find out value of this function, cos theta and this function. So what we will do, we'll simplify these values. Obviously cos theta, sin theta, we cannot do anything, but tan theta we can write as sin theta upon cos theta, and this cot theta is cos theta upon sin theta. So by cross multiplication, this numerator is as it is. Now cos theta minus sin theta divided by cos theta plus sin theta, and sin theta minus cos theta divided by sin theta. So this numerator, this cos theta will go in numerator and it will become cos square theta. Now this sin theta will go in numerator, it will become sin square theta, and denominator will be cos theta minus sin theta and sin theta minus cos theta. Now see, denominators are near about same, only the value that, only the thing is that this minus sign is there. So what we will do, we will take out minus sign common from this denominator. So we'll take out common as minus sign. So what will become? This cos theta will become cos plus cos theta, and this minus sin theta. And already cos theta minus sin theta in first term, cos theta minus sin theta is there. So now denominators are same, in both denominators are same. So we can write cos square theta minus sin square theta divided by cos theta minus sin theta. So this cos square theta minus sin square theta divided by cos theta minus sin theta. Now again, as earlier question, cos square theta minus sin square theta, we can write cos theta minus sin theta, cos theta plus sin theta, because a square minus b square is equals to a plus b and a minus b. We know this, a minus b. That's why we can write this cos square theta minus sin square theta as cos theta minus sin theta plus cos into cos theta plus sin theta, and denominator is as it is, cos theta minus sin theta. Now these two terms, this term will get cancelled, cos theta minus sin theta, cos theta minus sin theta. So the answer will be cos theta plus sin theta. So by this way we can solve the given this relations, trigonometric function. Sin theta, cos theta we cannot do anything, but tan theta, cos theta, cosec theta, all these values we can transfer into sin theta and cos theta. So when we simplify it, we will get answer. Question number 6, sine of a minus b is equals to half and cos of a plus b is equals to half. So we can write this sine of a minus b as a minus b sine of inverse half. Similarly, a plus b is equals to cos of inverse half. As we know that sine 30 is equals to sine 30 is equals to half and cos 60 is equals to half. Okay, now we can, obviously this sine of inverse 1 by 2 is 30 degree, and a plus b, so cos of inverse 60 is equals to cos of inverse half is equals to 60 degrees. So a minus b is equals to 30 and a plus b is equals to 30 we got. So let's number these equations as number 1 and number 2 equation. So let's solve these equations for the value of a and b. So first what we will do, we will add this equation 1 and 2. When we add this equation, means a minus b is equals to 30 degree, a plus b is equals to 60 degree for the values of a and b. We will add, so this bb will get cancelled and we will get here 2a is equals to 90. So 2a is equals to 90, so obviously a is equals to 45 degrees. Similarly, the values of b is equals to 45 minus 30 is equals to 15. We can put the value of a in any equation. We put in equation 1. So we get here value of a b as 45 degree minus 30 degrees equals to 15 degrees. So answer is 45 degree and 15 degrees. Question number 7. 1 minus cos alpha plus sin alpha upon 1 plus sin alpha. We have to find out the value of this. 1 minus cos alpha plus sin alpha upon 1 plus sin alpha. And it's given that 2 sin alpha upon 1 plus cos alpha plus sin alpha equals to y. Some values are given. So we have to find out the value of this. So what we will do, see, we cannot put any values. Cos alpha, sin alpha are there. So we cannot put as cos or sin as any other value. So what we will do, we will try to convert this whole function as in terms of given value. So in terms of y value. So let's solve. As we know that, see, we will rearrange this. 1 plus sin alpha minus cos alpha. We are just rearranging. We are not adding or putting any values. We are rearranging this given. So 1 plus sin alpha, this 1, this plus sin alpha and cos alpha divided by 1 plus sin alpha. What we will do here, we will rationalize it. Means this 1 plus sin alpha minus cos alpha is there. So we will put here plus sign, 1 plus sin alpha and cos alpha. Similarly, denominator 1 plus sin alpha plus cos alpha. Now, let's multiply. As we know that a minus b and a plus b is equals to what? A square minus b square? A square minus b square. So this 1 plus sin alpha is a term and this cos alpha is b term. A and this b. So a square means 1 plus sin alpha square minus cos square alpha divided by denominator is as it is. So let's square the 1 plus sin alpha term. So 1 plus 2 sin alpha plus sin square alpha minus cos square alpha divided by denominator. As we know that this cos square alpha, this cos square alpha term is, we know that cos square alpha is equal to 1 minus sin square alpha. So what we will do, we put the value minus cos square alpha as 1 plus sin square. Because of this minus sign, it has become minus 1 plus sin square alpha. So remaining terms are the same. 1 plus 2 sin alpha sin square alpha minus this minus 1 and plus sin square alpha divided by denominator 1 plus sin alpha, 1 plus sin alpha cos alpha. So this sin square alpha will become this sin square alpha, this sin square alpha will become 2 sin square alpha and this 1 minus 1 will get cancelled. So this is 2 sin alpha plus 2 sin square alpha and denominator is as it is. So we can take out 2 sin alpha common. So 2 sin alpha here will be 1 plus sin alpha divided by 1 plus sin alpha, 1 plus sin cos alpha. Now from numerator and this denominator, these two terms will get cancelled. So answer is 2 sin alpha upon 1 plus sin alpha plus cos alpha. And it's given in the question. The value of this 2 sin alpha divided by 1 plus sin alpha is y. So our answer is also y. So the value of the cos alpha, the value of this cos alpha plus sin alpha is value of 1 plus sin alpha cos alpha upon 1 plus sin alpha is equals to y. So answer is y. Same. So what is the value is given as same as that. Answer is y. Question number 8. Here x is equals to r sin a cos c, y is equals to r sin a sin c and z is equals to r cos a. These three values are given and we have to find out value of x square plus y square plus z square. So let's write down this r square. X square means obviously r sin a cos c, so r square sin square a cos square c. Y square means r square sin square a sin square c. Z square means r square cos square a. So see, the here sin square and r square term is there, sin square r square term, here not. So what we will do, we will take out this r square sin square a common from these two terms, this term and this term. So it will become only remaining thing is cos square c. So cos square c plus sin square c plus r square cos square a as it is. So this r square sin square a into 1, because we know that cos square a plus sin square a is equals to 1. So value of this equation, value of this equation will be 1. So answer is as r square sin square a plus r square a cos square a. Now again we can take out r square common. So sin square a plus cos square a. And we know that the value of this sin square a cos square a is equals to 1. So finally answer is x square plus y square plus z square is equals to r square. So this is the answer. Question number 9. Tan theta plus cot theta equals to 2. So we have to find out value of sec theta. So let's solve it. We know that tan theta plus cot theta is equals to 2 cosec theta 2 theta. We have this relation. So what we will do? We put the values of this. It's given that tan theta plus cot theta equals to 2. This is given. So we will put the values tan theta plus cot theta in this relation. In this relation we will put the values. So we get here 2 cosec 2 theta is equals to 2. We got here. So obviously cosec 2 theta is equals to 1. Cosec 2 theta is equals to 1. So 1 upon cosec theta is nothing but 1 upon sin theta. So we can write this cosec 2 theta is equals to 1 as 1 upon sin 2 theta is equals to 1. So sin 2 theta is equals to 1. We got here value of sin 2 theta is equals to 1. So I can write this equation sin 2 theta is equals to 1 as 2 theta is equals to sin of inverse 1. I can write. So and this is nothing but sin of inverse 1 value sin 90 is equals to 1. We know that. So that's why sin of inverse 1 value is 90 degree. So obviously theta is equals to 45 degree. Because 2 theta is equals to 90, that's why theta is equals to 45 degrees. As here we got the value of theta. So we can find out any value, sin theta, cos theta, tan theta. Here only we have to find out value of sec theta. So sec theta is nothing but sec 45. So sec 45, so sec theta. So sec theta, finally answer is sec theta is equals to root 2. Because sec theta means sec 45 is equals to root 2. That's why sec theta is equals to root 2. This is the answer. Question number 10. Here we have to find out value of this expression 1 minus sin square y, 1 plus cos y sin y, minus sin y upon cos y. See, if we solve directly, we cannot put any values or we cannot solve it further. So what we will do? We will do first, we will rearrange this, these two functions and these two. So what we will get? We have 1 minus sin square upon 1 plus cos y. So we will solve this part first and then this part. And then we will add these two parts. So let's solve. Now 1 minus sin square upon 1 plus cos y. So we cannot put and if we put the sin square y is equals to 1 minus cos square y, we will not get any value. So we will do cross multiplication. Means 1 plus cos y in minus sin square y. So here we get 1 plus cos y minus sin square y by doing this cross multiplication. And denominator is 1 plus cos y. Now this plus. Similarly here also we cannot put any value sin y, cos y. So what we will do? We will do cross multiplication. So 1 plus cos y means 1 plus cos y and 1 minus cos y is 1 minus cos square y. Because we know that a plus b into a minus b is a square minus b square. And this sin y and this sin y is minus sin square y divided by denominator sin y into 1 minus cos y. Now this part 1 plus cos y minus sin square y. From this we cannot get, but if I rearrange this 1 and this minus sin square y, 1 minus sin square y, so I will get cos square y value and this cos y is as it is and denominator is also as it is. Now this 1 minus sin square y is cos square y plus cos y and 1 plus cos y. Now this part 1 minus cos y, see here 1 minus cos square y and sin square y is there. So what we will do, this cos square y and this sin square y and minus sign is there. So we can take out minus sign common. So this will become sin square y plus cos square y. Now when this minus sin square y plus cos square y, when we take out this minus sign common, this will become sin square y plus cos square y. And we know that sin square y plus cos square y is equals to 1. So what will come answer? 1 minus 1. So when 1 minus 1 value, so 1 minus 1 is obviously 0. So this part, this whole part will become 0. Okay, so the answer is 0. The whole part is 0. So therefore, first part cos square y means if this cos square y plus cos y divided by 1 plus cos y, so I can take out from numerator cos y common. So this is cos y and this is 1 plus cos y divided by 1 plus cos y, and this 1 plus cos y, 1 plus cos y will get cancelled, and therefore answer is cos y. So answer of this expression is cos y. When we rearrange the question and we solve it, we got cos y as value. Question number 11. Here this value of this expression is given, 7 sin square theta plus 3 cos square theta is equals to 4, and we have to find out value of tan theta. So how can we find out the value of tan theta? Only the way is that if I know the value of sin theta and cos theta, I can find out the value of tan theta, because tan theta is equals to sin theta upon cos theta. So what we will do, we will solve this question expression for the value of sin theta and cos theta. Only one equation is given and here two unknowns are there, sin theta and cos theta. So if I have two unknowns, I must have two equations. So what we will do, from the standard expressions we know that this sin square theta plus cos square theta is equals to 1. This is the standard formula, sin square theta plus cos square theta equals to 1. So I got here second equation, sin square theta plus cos square theta, and given is 7 sin square theta, 3 cos square theta. So let's multiply this equation with 3, this equation with 3. So 3 sin square theta plus 3 cos square theta is equals to 3. This is the equation number 2. So let's solve this equation 1 and equation 2. What we can do here, if I subtract this equation 1 minus equation 2, equation 1 minus equation 2, so 7 sin square theta plus 3 cos square theta equals to 4, it's given. And we got here 3 sin square theta plus 3 cos square theta equals to 3. So let's subtract. So here this will get cancelled and I will get 4 sin square theta equals to 1. So here I got 4 sin square theta equals to 1. So obviously 4 sin square theta equals to 1 means sin square theta is equals to 1 by 4. So sin theta is equals to 1 by 2. And we know that cos square theta is equals to 1 minus sin square theta. So that's why, or you can put value of sin theta in any expression, this equation or this equation, you can put at anywhere, or you can solve by the using this equation also. So cos theta is equals to under root of 1 minus 1 by 4, so is equals to root 3 by 2. So here we got the value of sin theta and cos theta. So tan theta is equals to sin theta upon cos theta, value of tan theta is equals to 1 by root 3. So here we got the answer, tan theta is equals to 1 by root 3. Question number 12. Here we have to find out the value of this expression, given expression. Means to find out the value of given expression means we have to simplify it. See here, all terms are cos terms. Cos 6x, cos 4x, cos 2x, cos 5x, 3x, x. So all are in cos terms. So by using this formula, cos A plus cos B. 2 cos A, we can simplify this given expression, 2 cos of A plus B divided by 2 into cos of A minus B. So let's just split this 6 cos 4x. So cos 4x plus 5 cos 4x plus 5, see here on 5 is there. So from this 15 cos 2x, from this 15 cos 2x, we are taking only 5 cos 2x and remaining is 10 cos 2x. So here we will write 10 cos 2x. Why? Because here see, here only 1 10 is there. So I can take out 10 common from this equation also. So this 10 cos 2x plus 1. So after some practice you will come to know how to split the given equation so that to convert it in the standard equations. So because here cos A plus cos B means this cos 6x plus cos 4x must be there. No constant term is there. So that's why we are just taking only one cos 4x from this 6 cos 4x. So here cos 4x and remaining is 5 cos 4x, that's why here 5 and this cos 4x. So here cos 2x, 15 cos 2x is there, so we are taking only 5 cos 2x from there, so only cos 2x plus, so remaining is 10 cos 2x. So here we are taking here 10 common, so 10 cos 2x plus 1. Similarly in the denominator, but in denominator we will take it is at as it is, cos 5x plus 5 cos 3x plus 10 cos x. So here 5 cos, same denominator is same. Let's solve this. Here 6 cos x 4 cos 4x. So cos a plus cos b means 2 cos of a plus b. So 6x plus 5x is 10x. So 6x plus 5x is 10x divided by 2 means 5x. 6x minus 4x is 2x divided by 2 is only x. So this is cos 2 cos 5x into cos x plus 5 into 2 into 4x plus 2x is 6x divided by 2 is 3x. So 4x minus 2x divided by 2 is x plus 10 into, we have this 1 plus cos 2x is 2 cos square x. This is standard equation. So 10 into 2 into cos square x. So list here in all equation expression there is 2 cos x terms is there. 2 cos x, 2 cos x. So let's take out 2 cos x common. So we'll get here cos 4x plus 5 cos 3x plus 10 cos x divided by cos 5x plus 5 cos 3x plus 10 cos x. So we can cut this because denominator and numerator are the same terms. Same terms are there. So therefore answer is 2 cos x. Question number 13. Here we have to find out the value of this expression tan square theta sec square theta into cot square theta minus cos square theta. As we know that tan theta into cot theta is equals to 1. This tan theta and cot theta is equals to 1. We know that. That's why we will multiply this bracket with this tan theta and this. Okay. So that we will get one value. So let's simplify it. Sec square theta as it is. Or you can put 1 upon cos square theta also. And tan square theta into cot square theta minus tan square theta into cot square theta. Here we multiply this tan square theta with this bracket. So here we got tan square theta into cot square theta. We know that is 1. Or you can put also sin square theta upon cos square theta into cos square theta upon sin square theta. So obviously 1. Now here tan square theta into cos square theta. So sin square theta upon cos square theta into cos square theta. So here this will get cancelled. This will get cancelled. We will get here 1. And this cos square theta and this cos square theta will get cancelled. Here we got sin square theta. So 1 minus sin square theta. We know that 1 minus sin square theta is cos square theta. So that's why 1 upon cos square theta and this cos square theta, it will get cancelled and we got the value of this expression as 1 and this is the answer. Question number 14. Here we have to find out value of this expression 5 sin 2a, 3 sin a and 4 cos a. So for that, I must know the value of sin 2a, sin a and cos a. So let's find out these values. It's also given 3 tan a minus 4 equals to 0. So obviously tan a is equals to 4 by 3. When we take this 4 on the right hand side, it will become 4 plus 4 and divided by 3. So this is tan a, 4 by 3. So from this value, we can find out value of cos a and sin a. Why? Because we know that in right angle triangle, if tan theta is equals to perpendicular upon base and its values are given 4 by 3. So obviously this hypotenuse will be 5, must be 5 by Pythagoras theorem under root of 16 minus 16 plus 9 is equals to 25. So that's why we can find out value of cos A, because here we know all these sides 5, 4 and 3. We got the 3 values, so we can write cos A. So cos A means minus 3 by 5 and sin A will be obviously 4 by 5. Why minus here? Because this minus is there because it's given that angle A is in third quadrant. This is first, this is second and this is third and this is fourth quadrant. And this is in angle A is in third quadrant. And we know add sugar to coffee by the it means here all signs are plus. Sin, cos, tan, cosec, sec all are plus. Here in second quadrant only sin is positive and other ratios are negative. Here only tan is positive, others are negative. Here only in fourth quadrant only cos is positive. So obviously if this angle is in third quadrant, so obviously cos A is equals to minus 3 by 5. Why? Because it's in third quadrant and in third quadrant only tan theta is positive and others are negative. Similarly, sin A is equals to minus 4 by 5. So we got here value of sin A, cos A. So we got sin A, we got cos A, only sin 2A. We don't know the value of sin 2A now. So we have formula. Sin 2A is equals to 2 tan A upon 1 plus tan square A. This is the formula. For that we must know tan A value and tan square A value. Yes, we have this tan A value. This is tan A is equal to 4 by 3. So let's put here tan A is equal to 4 by 3. So 2 into 4 by 3 divided by 1 plus tan square A means 16 by 9. because tan is equals to 4 by 3, that's why 16 by 9. Let's solve it. This will become 8 by 3 divided by 25 by 9. It means 8 by 3 into 9 by 25. So your 3, 3, so it will come 24 by 25. So you got the value of sine 2 as 24 by 25. Let's put the values in this expression. So what we will get? 5 into sine 2a. So 24 by 25 from here. 5 into 24 by 25 plus 3 into minus 4 by 5 minus 4 by 5 plus 4 into minus 3 by 5. So this 5 will get cancelled and this minus 12 by 5. So it will come 24 by 5 minus 12 by 5 minus 12 by 5. It will come 0. So value of this expression is 0. Question number 15. Here we have to find out value of this expression tan a plus ak minus 1 upon tan a minus ak plus 1. We have to find out value of this expression. So if I put the value sin a upon cos a plus cos a upon sin a minus 1, I will not get anything. You can try it also. I will get the same things what I am doing, what here, same things. So what we will do, first of all, we will try to cancel out this denominator. For this, I must get the same values as denominator in the numerator. It means I have to do some arrangements here so that I will get the same tan a minus ak plus 1 in the numerator. So what we can do in numerator is, here minus 1 is there. As we know that sec square a minus tan square a is equals to 1. So I can put this 1 value as sec square a minus tan square a. I can put so that I can take out common tan a plus ak from the numerator, because again sec square a minus tan square a is nothing but sec a plus tan a and sec a minus tan a, because we know that a square minus b square is equals to a plus b and a minus b. So let's put sec square a minus tan square a is equals to sec a plus tan a and sec a minus tan a, and this is tan a plus sec a minus this values, and denominator is as it is. Now here two terms are same, tan a plus ak and sec a plus tan a. So let's take out common tan a plus ak. So what will come here? 1 minus. So only sec a minus tan a is there. So 1 minus sec a minus tan a. Now also we cannot cancel it out, because in denominator plus tan a is there, minus sec a is there and plus 1. So what we will do here, we will multiply this with minus sign to the bracket. So what we will get? Plus tan a will be there, because this minus will become plus, and this minus with sec a is minus sec a, and this plus is already there, so plus 1. So tan a minus sec a plus 1, and in denominator is also there tan a minus sec a plus 1. So let's cancel it out. So what we will get? Tan a plus sec a. So answer is tan a plus sec a. Question number 16. Here we have to find out value of this expression 1 upon tan 3a minus tan a minus 1 upon cot 3a minus cot a. So in this question we can put the value of tan 3 and cot 3a as sin 3a, tan 3a is equals to sin 3 upon cos 3a minus sin a upon cos a. Similarly here, 1 upon cos 3a divided by sin 3a minus cos a upon sin a. Now next step will be obviously cross multiplication. So let's do sin 3a, this sin 3a into this cos a and sin 3a minus sin a and cos 3a minus sin a and cos 3a. And obviously denominators cos a into cos 3a will go in numerator and it will be cos a and cos 3a minus 1 upon cos 3a into sin a, cos 3a into sin a minus sin 3a into cos a and sin a, sin 3a. And obviously denominators sin a sin 3a will go in numerator, sin a sin 3a, and minus sign is there. So see, in denominator this cos a sin 3 is there and this cos a sin 3 is there, minus sin a cos 3a plus sin a cos 3a. Now denominator is same, values are same, only the signs are different. So what we will do, we can take out this minus sign common. So this minus will become plus here. And this minus cos a sin 3 will become cos a plus sin 3 and minus sin a cos 3 a. And here denominator is obviously cos a sin 3 minus sin a cos 3 a. So here this all term, this part is same, cos a cos 3 a cos a sin 3 a this. Only we are changing here sign. This minus, because of this minus common, it will become plus, and sin 3 cos a minus sin a cos 3 a, and numerator is same, sin a sin 3. Now see, from the values, as we have seen sin a sin 3 a cos a sin a cos 3 a, it means by using this formula, sin a cos b minus cos a sin b, we can write here sin 3 a minus a. By using that formula, we can write in denominator, see here, cos a sin 3 a minus sin a cos 3 a. So we can write sin 3 a minus a. See, denominator is same. So either you join it earlier or no problem. But denominator same. So by using this formula, sin of a minus b, sin a cos b minus cos a sin b, we can write sin of 3 a. In this case, a is 3 a minus b is a. So sin of 3 a minus a. So same way. As same way, in numerator, there is a cos a and cos 3 a, sin a, sin 3 a. So cos of a minus b will become cos a, cos b. We have this formula. This is the standard formula. Cos of a minus b is cos a, cos b plus sin a, sin b. So you have to mug up all the formulae, and from the formulae you can find out what will be the answer. So you must know all formulae. So cos a, cos 3 a plus sin a, sin 3 a. Cos terms and sin terms are there. So obviously we will use this formula. So in numerator, cos a cos 3 a plus sin a sin 3 a divided by sin 2 a. So it will become cos of 3 a minus a divided by sin 2 a. And cos of 3 a minus a, this is cos 2 a divided by sin 2 a. So obviously the answer is cot of 2 a. So answer is cot 2 a. Question number 17. Here we have to find out the value of this expression, tan 5x into tan 3x into tan 2x. So from the values only we will come to know that if we know that 5x is equals to 3x plus 2x, so obviously we will use this formula, tan of a plus b is equals to tan a plus tan b divided by 1 minus tan a tan b. So 5x plus 3x plus 2x, so tan 5x, I can write tan 5x as tan of 3x plus 2x, I can write. So tan 5x by this formula, tan 5x is equals to tan 3x. So in this case, a is this 3x value, suppose, and this is b. So obviously tan 3x will come tan a plus tan b. So tan 3x plus tan 2x divided by 1 minus tan 3x into tan 2x. Now next step must be obviously cross multiplication. So tan 5x minus this tan 5x and this tan 3x. This tan 5x into this 1, it will become tan 5x, tan 5x minus tan 3x into tan 2x, tan 5x, tan 3x, tan 2x is equals to tan 3x plus tan 2x. Now, right hand side, we can take this tan 5x. We got here all three terms, tan 5x, tan 3x and tan 2x. So obviously, tan 5x, tan 3x into tan 2x is equals to this tan 3x plus tan 2x. We are taking this on this side. So, and it will come on the left hand side. So, tan 5x minus tan 3x minus tan 2x. So, this is the answer. This is the answer of tan 5x into tan 3x into tan 2x is equals to tan 5x minus tan 3x minus tan 2x. Question number 18. Here we have to find out value of tan of x plus y. So, tan of x plus y, and the values are given, sin x upon sin y is equals to half, and cos x upon cos y is equals to 3 by 2. So these values are given, and we have to find out value of tan of x plus y. So obviously, tan of x plus y means if I put sin of x plus y upon cos of x plus y, I will not get any values. So what we will do, we will use this formula. Tan of x plus y is tan x plus tan y 1 minus tan x tan y. This is the formula. We know this is the standard formula. So in this case, we must know the value of tan x, tan y, tan x and tan y. We can find out tan x, tan y values because we have sin x, sin y separately. So let's find out. Now I can write this sin x upon sin y as sin y is equals to 2 sin x. Similarly, cos x is equals to 3 cos y is equals to 2 cos x I can write. So we will use these values. These two values we will use for solving the values of tan x, tan y. Now, from these equations, means sin x and sin y tan x, from this first and this second equations, we can find out value of tan x tan y. Divide this equation by this equation, I will get 1 by 3, tan x upon tan y, because sin x upon cos x is 1 by 2 divided by 3 by 2. So this 2 and this 2 will get cancelled and I will get the value 1 by 3. So tan y is equals to 3 tan x. So I got the values of tan y in terms of x also. So let's convert whole equation in terms of x. So let's put the values. Tan x plus tan y, from here tan y is equals to 3 tan x. So 3 tan x divided by 1 minus tan x into 3 tan x. So let's solve it. So tan of x plus y is equals to 4 tan x divided by 1 minus 3 tan square x. From this, from here, see, tan x plus 3 tan x, it will become 4 tan x. 1 minus tan x into 3 tan x, it will become 1 minus 3 tan square x. Now, here we don't have the values of tan x or tan square x. So, we will put the values. We will find out the values of sin x cos x. So, we will get tan x value. So, let's put the values. So, we have sin square x, sin square y plus cos square y is equals to 1. So, put the value of sin x, sin y. From here, we know sin y is equals to, from here sin y is equals to 2 sin x and cos y is equals to 2 by 3 cos square x. So let's put these values. So 4 sin square x plus 4 cos square x divided by 9 is equals to 1. So this is the our equation A. Now again we can write this equation sin square theta plus cos square theta in any values. Means that instead of that theta we can put any values. Here y we put and we can put x also. Because this is a standard equation, that's why. So sin square x plus cos square x is equals to 1. So I can, to get the values of sin x and cos x, I can multiply this equation by 4. So let's multiply. 4 sin square x plus 4 cos square x is equals to 4. Because we have two unknowns, sin x, cos x, we must know two equations, that's why. So here we will multiply this equation by 4. We got here 4 sin square x and cos square, 4 cos square x is equals to 4. This is our equation B. Now let's solve this equation A and B. We will do addition, subtraction. So this 4 sin square x plus 4 by 9 cos square x is equals to 1 divided by 4 sin square x, plus minus 4 sin square x plus 4 cos square x is equals to 4. Now let's subtract. This will get cancelled and this 4 by 9, it will become 4 by 9 minus 4 cos square x. And 1 minus 4 is obviously minus 3. Now cos square x value is 3 into 9 divided by 32. This minus sign will become plus, because minus minus are on both sides. That's why it will get cancelled. And 3 into 9 divided by 32 is equals to 27 by 32. Now we know that sin square x plus cos square x is equals to 1. Sin square x plus cos square x is equals to 1. That's why sin square x value is 1 minus cos square x. 1 minus cos square x. So 1 minus cos square, from here we got the values of cos square x. So 1 minus 27 by 32 is equals to 5 by 32. So obviously tan square x is equals to 5 by 27. Now put the values in this equation. 4 tan x on 1 minus 3 tan square x. Let's put the values. 4 into tan x. Tan x is root 5 by 3 into 33. 2 into 3. Why here? Because we know that 27 I can write as 3 into root 3, that's why. So this root 5 upon 3 into root 3, under root of 5, because tan square is there, that's why. So 3 root 3, 1 minus 3 into 5 by 27 is equals to 4 into root 5 into 9, 3 root 3 minus 4. So sort, we got the values as 15. So tan of x plus y is equals to root 15. This is the answer. See, in this case 5, 3 root 3 is not there because this is tan square x. So root 27, 5 by 27, 9 into 3. So we can write then 3 into root 3. Under root of that is 3 into root 3. That's why only 5 by 27. Now 4 tan 4 tan x value is there, so tan value is under root of 5 and under root of 27. So tan x value is under root of 5 and under root of 27. So under root of 27 is nothing but 3 into 9, under root of 3 into 9. So obviously we can write this as root 5 and divided by 3 root 3. So here tan x value is this, not under, because all there is a square, that's why. So root 5 upon 3 into root 3, 1 minus 3 into 10 square x, 5 into 27. So solve it, we will get the value as root 15. And here also this 3 will get cancelled, this 4 and 3 root 5 upon root 3. So this again here for root 5 into 3. So root 5 3 upon root 5 into 3 upon root 3. So this root 5 into root 3 into root 3 I can write, divided by this root 3. So 1 3 will get cancelled. It will come root 5 into root 3. And we can write this as under root of 15. So that's why this is the answer. Question number 19. Here we have to find out the value of A plus 2B. Value of the angles A plus 2B. And it's given 3 sin 2A minus 2 sin 2B is equals to 0. So I can write this equation as sin 2B is equals to 3 by 2 sin 2A. It's also given 3 sin square A is equals to 1 minus 2 sin square B. Now obviously this must be is equals to cos 2B. We have standard formula for this, cos 2a is equals to 1 minus sin 2 sin square a. That's why. So 1 minus 2 sin square b is equals to cos 2b. Now as we have to find out value of a plus 2b, let's do cos of a plus 2b. Why we are doing a cos of a plus 2b? See, if I do this, sin of a plus 2b is equals to sin a cos 2b and cos a sin 2b. Now here I have only cos 2b values and sin 2b values. I don't have sin a or cos a. So we cannot do anything further. So I will not get any values. That's why we are solving by this formula. Cos of A plus 2B is cos of A cos 2B minus sin of A cos 2B. So let's put the values. Cos A into cos 2B is 3 sin square A. So 3 sin square A minus sin A is as it is. And cos 2B. Now sin 2B. So sin 2B is 3 by 2 sin 2a. So sin a as it is, 3 by 2 is there and sin 2a. Now 3 cos a sin square a minus, now this 3 by 2 sin a sin 2a. As we know that sin 2a is equals to 2 sin a cos a. So if I put this sin 2a as this value, 2 sin a cos a. So this sin a and this sin square a, this 3. So 2 sin square and this 2 and this 2 will get cancelled. That's why 3 sin square a into cos a. Now this cos a sin square a minus 3 sin square, same terms are there. This term and this term is same. That's why the value is 0. That's why a plus 2b. And cos of inverse 0 is pi by 2. Cos of inverse 0 is pi by 2, means 90 degree. So that's why answer is pi by 2. Answer is a plus 2b is pi by 2. Question number 20. Here we have to find out value of tan theta, sec theta and cosec theta. So it's given value of sin theta is equals to a square minus b square upon a square plus b square. It's given. From sin theta value we can find out value of cos square theta, because cos square theta is equals to 1 minus sin square theta. Now let's put the values. 1 minus a square minus b square upon a square plus b square whole square. So let's solve it. By cross multiplication, this a square plus b square into 1 is a square plus b square square minus a square minus b square square, and denominator is a square plus b square square. Now let's solve this terms. A square plus b square square is a raised to power 4 plus b raised to power 4 plus 2a square b square. Now minus, because there is a minus sign. And square of a minus b is a square minus 2ab plus b square. But because of this sign, we will multiply this sign minus sign to the bracket directly. So a square minus b square square is a raised to power 4 plus a raised to power 4, but because of this minus sign it will come minus a raised to power 4 plus minus 2 a square b square, but because of minus it will become plus 2 a square b square minus b raised to power 4 divided by denominator as it is. Now this a raised to power 4, this a raised to power 4 will get cancelled, this b raised to power, this is b raised to power 4 will get cancelled, and this 2 a square b square and this a 2 square b square will become plus 4 a square b square divided by this. So we got the value of cos square theta 4 a square b square upon a square b square and square. So value of cos theta is 2 a b upon a square plus b square. So 2 a b upon a square plus b square. Now answer of tan theta will be sin theta upon cos theta, we know that is equals to sin theta value. Sin theta value is a square minus b square upon a square plus b square. It's given. Now we got here cos theta value. So 2ab upon a square plus b square. This a square plus b square, this a square b square will get cancelled. So here it will come a square minus b square upon 2ab. Now we got the value of tan theta. Now sec theta. Sec theta is equals to 1 upon cos theta, we know that. Is equals to cos theta value from here. A square plus b square upon 2ab, because inverse of cos theta, that's why this a square plus b square will go in numerator and 2ab in denominator. Similarly, cosec theta is equals to 1 upon sin theta, a square plus b square upon a square minus b square, and this is the answer of tan theta, sec theta and cosec theta.